All right, gang, welcome back to Cooking with ENV, and I got another one for you. It deals with hamburgers. The last video, I stuffed a tomato in a hamburger. I hope everyone enjoyed that. I think it was very delicious. But look, we're doing hamburgers. We're going to amp them up this time. In this burger mix, I got some onion powder, crushed red peppers, pulled parsley, oregano, and I got some broth base. And this is beef broth base. And these little bits and pieces that you see right here, here's some butter. It's about 2 tablespoons of butter, real butter, salted butter. Here's the pepper jack cheese. There's about 4 slices of pepper jack cheese in there. And you can see that broth base right there and all the other ingredients. And you can see the pick of that crushed red pepper. And also, you got fresh garlic in here. Use my garlic press. The garlic is all in here. There's garlic goodness all in here. See these pieces right here? This is our butter. It's our butter right here. Here's our pepper jack cheese. It's gonna be delicious. We're all gonna do this on a burger press. I'm gonna show you that. I put a video out on that. Just check the list. How to press your own burgers. This is gonna be outstanding, folks. I can't wait to taste this. One thing I didn't do, and I'll show you on camera, I didn't put too much salt. Now, once you put burgers on salt, you're going to lose a lot of seasonings. I know this beef broth base is salty, but we're just going to do a pinch of salt just to get it going. And we'll have just the right amount of seasoning once it's finished on the grill. I wanted to show you the garlic. Oh, here's some of that oregano. Some of that oregano in there. Yeah, right here. But the garlic is so finely grated in there that it tends to disappear within the meat. Well, this smells delicious. They're gonna get smell-o-vision one day. They got everything else. They're putting civilians on the moon so they can transmit some smells through the air. But until then, if you haven't yet, please subscribe, like, and share, and also comment. But the most important thing is to liking. Hit that thumbs up, and also most important is to share. We really appreciate it. And next time you see me, I'm going to have these out on the Kamado Grill. Haven't named these yet. I'm just gonna say, let's name them garlic. I don't like that. Pepper Jack garlic burgers. How about that? Pepper Jack garlic burgers. All right, guys, stay tuned. Be right back. All right, we are back, and these burgers are looking delicious. Hold on for a sec, y'all. I'm gonna bring y'all 360. Bam! All right. the burgers are nice and formed. If you don't have one of these burger presses, I suggest you get one. You can buy them at Amazon or probably any of the other big box stores. But they work great. Now in here, you can see the pepper jack cheese. You see the butter. You can see that broth beef base. You can also see the crushed red peppers, the garlic. Well, you really can't see the garlic too tough, but You can smell it. I can definitely smell it. But these burgers weighed in probably at about 7.5 pounds each, 10.5 ounces each. And the Kamado Joe is now getting hot, getting ready for these delicious looking burgers. Now I'm going to be cooking these kind of like reverse sear. I'm going to cook them on the low side first, get some of that hickory smoke that I put in there. And then once it comes up to maybe about 110, I'll go ahead and switch it over to the hot side, get a nice sear on them. All right, should be delicious. And we're going to be serving these on some ballpark hot dog, hamburger buns. I had hot dogs yesterday. You need to go back there. But anyway, stay tuned. I'll give you all a peek when I got them on the grill. All right, don't go anywhere. All right, fam, we're out. And we're outside and we're back at the Kamado Joe. It's about 250 degrees. I really would like to get it down a little bit lower because I want to put some smoke on that on these hamburgers. And here they go. Absolutely looking delicious. We're going to get these on here. Let them smoke for a little bit. These flies out here are notorious. And if you notice, I lined the deflector shield with some aluminum foil just to keep everything pretty much clean. All right, another hack I want to do. Since they're smoking real slow, I'm going to get me some Kraft Hickory Smoked Barbecue Sauce on them. Just a smidget. I'm going to go ahead and put it in the center, and then it'll eventually run off into the rest of the burger. Just like that. Nothing special. Let's get that smoke on there. Also help keep it moist. All right, and that's it. We're gonna smoke these real slow, and I'm gonna bring you back, show you how the progress is. So stay tuned. All right, we're back, and right now we're gonna go ahead and get our burger buns on. I have slathered them with mayo. Let me know in the comment section if you use mayo on your burger buns and grill them. I know some people put butter on them and grill them, but mayo takes it to another level. All right, so we're gonna get these bad boys on. Here is the bottom. And we're just gonna get a nice little crisp on this. It makes a better eating experience. And here are our smoked burgers. Our burgers are smoking good right now. All right, everything's smelling good, looking good. I'm gonna let these get nice and crispy. And once I do that, I'm gonna take the burgers off, let it rest. Then we're gonna get this fire roaring. Then we're gonna put a nice sear on them. So stay tuned. All right, thank you for tuning back in with Cooking with EMV. And before I get started, if you haven't yet subscribed, like or share this video, please do, and give us a thumbs up. Those thumbs ups are needed. So let's get started with this burger. All right, she is perfectly smoked, nice and juicy. The fire is hot. We're just gonna go ahead and put this over a direct flame and get a sear it off. And if you don't mind, I'm gonna take you along for the ride so you can see. Pretty day here in the South Mississippi on the Gulf Coast. Very hot, very humid as usual. Definitely not like anything over there where my brother's at in Palm Desert. By the way, that video is coming soon. Val and I's Palm Desert vacation, so stay tuned for that. Hope everybody's enjoying their Saturday. Yesterday all day I've been working out in the front yard doing some gardening, if you would, or getting ready for a garden. I'm putting up like a concrete block around on the front of the house. I'll have to show it to you. And it's going to be our garden section. It's coming out pretty nice so far. But today, I just couldn't do anything today because of my knees and my back. It started hurting me real bad, so I thought I'd take a day off and continue it tomorrow. Some flames kissing up. And within a couple more days, people, we will have our gazebo up. The bar, which is going to be sitting right here, is coming in a couple of days. The ottoman has come today. Two ottomans have come today. And the furniture should be also delivered within the next couple of days. So we're very excited about this. All right, as you can see, the flames are kissing up on that burger. That's that butter that I put in that hamburger meat coming through. It should be nice and juicy. All right, ladies and gentlemen, next time you see me, I'm gonna have this plated up and then we're gonna do a taste test. So stick around, it's gonna be great. And here we go, guys. This is our finished product. It looks absolutely delicious. Let me get me a thumbnail on that. All right, let's build this puppy together. Oh, and our bread. Bread came out delicious. Got that mayo on there, a little char on it. Looks absolutely delicious. Can't wait to sink my teeth into this. So we'll go put that burger right there on that top bun. Actually, I got it reversed. Let's go to the bottom bun. Perfect. And I don't have any lettuce, but normally I will put lettuce, but we're gonna throw a little tomato on there. And for seasoning our tomato, we're gonna be using some of this Cavender's. This is Chef Jeffrey's go-to seasoning. All right, looks good. And we're gonna throw a little bit of Heinz ketchup on there. Not too much. And we already got mayo on our bun, toasted. Top her off like that. And there she is, guys. Our hamburger with salted butter and pepper jack cheese in the mix. Looks absolutely delicious. All right, let's take a taste test. I'm not even gonna cut it. I'm just going right in on it. All right, let me bring you up. Hey, everyone. Look at that. And that little bit of glaze of barbecue sauce I put on there made it just right. Perfectly cooked, juicy. That's another winner, guys. I'm Eric. Thank you for tuning in to Cooking with E&V. Hit that like button. Hit that thumbs up. And send me a comment. Let me know what's going on. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Have a happy Saturday, the rest of your Saturday, and a great Sunday. God bless.